The thing is, there are so many people sitting here now. They have different kinds of minds. There may be one basic thing, which is the mind's character, like fear, anger, and so on. But being brought up, being born in a setup, and being brought up in a certain way, you all think in a different way, in a different idea. And some people may have to deal more with anger. Some people have not that much anger. They are cool and calm, but there may be other problems. So what I'm trying to say, each person is different, differently made up. You can generalize the categories in some way and say that some people are more intellectual. Now, the different kinds of intellectual, mind you, but you can still generalize and put them in a bracket. Some are the people who live by the heart, who are more emotional. And some are the people who, from the time they are born, from the time they are young, they have sympathy for others. Everybody doesn't have that, mind you. It may be due to many things in the past, which we are not ready to accept. Okay, some accept, some don't. But so therefore, there must be different ways of dealing with it. So when Ramana Maharshi said that, he is talking, of course, in general of all humanity. But all human beings cannot live like Ramana Maharshi. Not so easy. Of course, I have no doubt in my mind that he had touched the ultimate, no question. But everybody cannot imitate Ramana Maharshi. You know, watch his life. He didn't do any sadhana. Right? And the teachings he gave of try to find out what your true essence is came after he had an experience. And that experience did not happen due to any sadhana, at least in this life that we know of. Forget about it, we don't know. Perhaps there was, otherwise I can't explain it. So therefore he, in his very young age of 15 or so, he experienced that he was not the body. It was not a thought, it was an experience. And from there he said, if I am not the body, then what am I? And went deep inside and found something. And he was trying to put it through to other people. How far an ordinary human being can touch that and how fast he can find out his true self? It's a debatable point. I'm not saying it is not impossible. It's not impossible, but it's a debatable point that he didn't have a guru. Everybody is not Ramana Maharshi. We can't claim that. We don't have. So these are exceptional, extraordinary yogis who taught something. While the essential fact that he taught is true, there is no question about that, but it is not easy for most people to practice it. It's not like simply closing our eyes and saying, who am I? You cannot find who you are. That's a mechanical process. It is no different from japa. Right? That's one thing. Now, who else did you say? Yogananda Paramahamsa. Okay. Now, the reason why Yogananda Paramahamsa said that Kriya Yoga is a way, because for a normal, ordinary human being who is not extraordinary, there may be some extraordinary people who can go directly in. I'm not debating this. But most people have their own conditionings, their own, they're not born with any special privileges or any special talents in this field. For such people, you need a step-by-step method to open your mind, like a practice. Now, actually, Kriya Yoga is not different from any of the Yoga Shastras taught by Patanjali. In fact, Patanjali starts his Sadhana Pada, that is practice chapter, by saying that we are going to enter into Kriya Yoga. Patanjali himself says Kriya Yoga, read the Sadhana Pada. So, Kriya Yoga need not necessarily mean a particular brand of Kriya Yoga. Understand what I mean? And all this thing about it being a jet plane path and all, I don't believe it. There is no jet plane anywhere. You have to work hard on it. If I had to sell it, I would have said it. I have nothing to sell. Okay? I'm not in the business. So, there is no jet plane path or any such jet planes or anything. It's why it can be used by most people is because it is a step-by-step thing in which you can move and see the results and move forward. Like the Ashtanga Yoga of Patanjali also is Kriya Yoga part of this. And there are many Kriyas in yoga. Now the Kriya that I teach comes from a certain parampara. Yogananda Paramahamsa also, his root parampara belongs to the same that we do. True. But it is a little bit misleading to say that it is a jet plane path. It will attract people, then they will try it for 6 months and 1 year and nothing is happening, then they get disgusted. What I have to say is, even if it is Kriya Yoga, which is a scientific training of step by step, you can move forward, you can see the results and go and so on, you must be ready to practice it. Don't forget the ultimate dictum of Patanjali, Nairantarya Abhyasena, regular practice is essential. Unending, Nairantarya. So that is why there are different approaches, and it depends on the character, on the person, and various things. That is why sometimes, like teaching spiritual matters or Kriya Yoga to 100 people, actually it is not a good idea. It should be one-to-one view, one person. But it doesn't seem to work because it's become like that. I also feel sometimes that, but what to do? Something is better than nothing, right? Something is better than nothing. And those who want to advance will somehow find their way into it. So it's our job to guide. So that's what it is. I know some very nice people who have no spiritual, no religion, nothing. By heart, they are people who like to help others in pain. Some of them I know don't even believe in any supreme power, nothing. They can't help it, they want to help. It's their compulsion from inside. For such people, that's a good path to follow. After some time, by helping others, they will gradually clear themselves of even the feeling of themselves. When the feeling of themselves goes, is an unconditioning of yourself, then there is only the infinite. Now, it may not be possible for everybody, mind you. If I say, I'm going to imitate that guy and I will not do any other, I will only do, it will work for 6 months, then you will give up. So, before you start your method and your sadhana, explore a bit. And then come to an understanding, instead of suddenly taking up something and not being able to do it. I say this also about Kriya. There are many people here who have taken Kriya from me. I think they might have practiced for 1 week and given up. What is the use? So I told them, sit here for the review so that becomes part of their own learning.